Hello, everyone. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Janice, and I'm the GUMS president for 2021. Before we get started tonight, I'd like to begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land on which we meet today and pay my respects to elders both past and present. Over the last 6 months, the GUMS team at the Sunshine Coast have put together our very first Med Review. Orchestrated by Josh Gardner, Alex Turnbull, and Georgia Jackson, and starring our very own students from backstage all the way through to the spotlight, we are beyond excited to welcome you to the inaugural Sunshine Coast Med Review. Tonight, you will join Bond, Q, Moneypenny, and Ryder, who represent the four stereotypical categories of med student, on their fight against the mysterious speculum. On stage, we will also meet some of our most iconic school staff. For those of you that don't know, I thought we'd do a quick introduction. So I'd like to introduce you to our boss lady, Jen. Jen, if you could please stand up for us. Everyone's best friend, Nat. The only course convener that actually knows what she's doing, Lisa. And your go-to man for clinical skills, Suge. Unfortunately, Judith and Ted couldn't join us tonight, but we hope we've done them justice with our casting. To all of the staff, we hope that you'll speak with us after this show. But if all of our cast end up in Gympie next year, we also understand. Jokes aside, we're truly grateful to belong to a school where doing a show like this feels natural and we're supported in all aspects. We would like to especially thank Rachel and Sophie for always making sure we have to have a place to rehearse every week, and Jen for supporting this show in every way. And to all of you for coming out and supporting us tonight, we are really, really grateful. Now for some quick housekeeping before we get started. Throughout the night, there will be a bar functioning at the back through the whole show. There are bathrooms available in the foyer and an intermission of 30 minutes if you can please hang on. We would appreciate if you could also put your phones on silent and refrain from any flash photography throughout the night. We also have a camera set up at the back, so please don't bump it, otherwise I will get very mad, and try not to walk in front of it. Also, keep your masks on you as you wander out, just normal COVID rules. But other than that, that's enough for me. Let's put our hands together for the inaugural Sunshine Coast Med Review.
This is the start. Hold your breath and valsalva. Feel the stage move and then hear my heart sing again. This is Revue. the show start. Griffith Med School, Med Review.
Moneypenny, penicillin.
I'm Q, Q Fever. I'm Richard, Richard Ryder, and I'm Bonk. Oh, since we got in the competition today,
yeah.
Now it's pass or fail, we share our notes instead.
Super dumb, oh, super dumb.
Here's a pass or fail, we get an MP.
Might not be you, Q, but we are doctors.
Get a cap and gown, will be the nicest of you now. We're the nicest, nicest. We're the nicest, nicest. We're the sugar and spices, nicest, doctrine.
Doctrine Town.
Woo!
My name's Bond. James Bond.
I'm Q. Commonwealth supported.
Bonded, hey?
Where's your GPA?
No, my name's Bond. I'm not.
Well, where's your GAMSAT? For me personally, the science section was the easiest, but I just scraped through with that essay.
Well, actually, my GAMSAT was.
How are you bonded?
Because you need empathy and communication skills to score well in an interview. And after 3 years of biomed with him, I can tell you he has neither.
I've never had trouble scoring in the past.
Oh, I bet you haven't. Oh. I haven't met you guys before.
I'm Moneypenny. We are going to be late.
Oh, well, my name's Richard, but everyone just calls me Dick. Dick Ryder.
Yeah, we're not going to call you that. How about just Ryder?
Yeah, Ryder.
And what's your background, Ryder?
I was actually a physio. Been out of uni for a couple of years. Probably a bit older than the rest of you.
Yeah. Look at them all out there. Is this the Griffith cohort? Should have gone to UQ.
Okay, great. We're all buds. Can we please get going to orientation?
Yeah, but does anyone know where the Sky Auditorium is?
Welcome, doctors in training, to Griffith, the greatest TAFE, I mean medical school, in the entirety of Bithynia. My name is Edward Weaver, OAM. I work as an ONG, but I got tired of looking at vaginas all day, so I'm here to pass on my wisdom to the next generation of doctors. If you need anything from the average age of a girl's med arc, to a pap smear, I'm at your service.
More like, I'm at your cervix.
Shut up, guys, I'm trying to listen.
Q, have you ever even seen a cervix?
Before I introduce you to the staff, let's make sure that everyone is here. Annoying, egomanic surgeon wannabe who thinks he's God's gift to women, but is really is deeply insecure with daddy issues.
Here.
Overeager med sci, who has never had a job and doesn't know how anything or anyone works in the real world.
Oh yeah, that's me.
Ambitious feminist student who thinks Hermione is the biggest boss-ass bitch ever. And will be ignored by the male characters, except for her female traits.
Is that supposed to be me?
Mature-age Thule, who wants to relive their old university days, couldn't handle full-time work, and who makes crude sexual jokes to hide their insecurities.
All right, that's me.
And finally, a random student with an ominous cough, which we will largely ignore, will be back to collaborate online. Great. With that out of the way, I'd now like to introduce to you to the backbone of this medical school. We refer to them as the Medically Intelligent Five, or MI5.
Yes, yes, yes. Hello, everyone. Thank you, Ted. My name is Suge. I have worked in many med schools. And therefore, I have lots of experience in working with students. And therefore, I will help whip you into shape to become the best doctors you can be. I was a surgeon in Sri Lanka before I chose to put down the scalpel because I love teaching so much.
Thank you, Suge. I would like to introduce Dr. Jen Williams, who will be overseeing your program.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jen. It is such an achievement that you've made it into medical school. You already look so much smarter than the last first years.
Obviously, my hard work in med sci has paid off, guys.
She literally says that every year, Dingus.
Oh, I love a woman who tells it how it is.
Well, you make me want to dry retch in my mouth.
As of now, you have 1,462.385 days left until you graduate as doctors. So make the most of it. One last thing. Look to your left, and then look to your right. Statistics say you're going to marry one of these people.
And remember, students, you're most fertile at 22 years old. Now, if you ever find yourself in a sticky situation, Nat is the one you should talk to.
Oh, I am so excited to have you all at the Sunshine Coast. All your bright, fresh faces just make me feel so cluggy. I want to give you all big hugs. Now, we have some great simulated patients ready for you to have deep and meaningful conversations with.
Psst. Hey, Ryder,
Maybe they'll teach us how to talk to girls and we can be smooth like Bond.
Oh, honey, you really have no idea, don't you?
Hi, everyone. I'm Lisa. I run the D-Lab component to your degree, otherwise known as the most organized part of Griffith Med. I'll be teaching you things like consent, negligence, and how cute Murphy Brown is. Just look at her.
Aww.
I'll also be teaching you how to get away with murder, because by the looks of all you, you're going to need it.
Thank you, Lisa. And lastly, we have Judith. Oh, sweet Judith. We know she's the one who runs the med school. If you have any questions at all, Judith is the one.
Yes, thank you, Ted. I'm so looking forward to meeting you all. Please feel free to email me if you have any concerns. If you need a day off, I'll ask that you let me know, let your team know. Get a COVID swab, do the hokey pokey, and make a blood sacrifice at the full moon. Thank you.
Great. Apart from a few guest lecturers that you'll meet, you'll have no idea what they're supposed to be teaching you, but you'll meet them along the way. Enjoy your orientation, and we'll see you in classes.
Wait. Before you go, what decks am I supposed to be adding into my Anki?
Yeah, and what are your names again, and what do you teach? I kind of zoned out after my killer cervix joke.
Griffith really has scraped the bottom of the barrel of these med school applications. There is only one book you need to know about to get through med school, and that is the Holy Bible, written by our Lord and Saviors, Tally and O'Connor.
Blessed be the fruit that is Tally and O'Connor.
Let's give these guys a proper introduction.
Hello, my name is Dr. Jen, and welcome to the Sunny Coast Griffith Campus.
Hello, my name is Dr. Suge, and I have come to share with you the most amazing book. It has so many awesome parts, you simply won't believe how much this book will change your life. Hello, listen closely now, I have come to share with you this Bible called Tally.
Hello, my name is Lisa Croft.
Hello.
Did you know that Tally lived here in Australia? You can read all about it now.
Hello.
In this nifty just book, just buy it when it is on sale.
Hello.
Hello, my name is Judith. Check out chapter 2 to learn how to examine boobs.
Hello.
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 You can see it here. It has a lot of information you can really use.
Hello.
Hi.
High yield.
You have a lovely smile.
It's an amazing book.
Bonjour.
Hello, my name is Dr. Nat.
Can we call Mips?
This book gives you the secret to eternal life.
Med school life
on Sunny Coast
is super fun.
Hello, ding dong.
And if you let us in, we'll show you how it can be done.
No, thank you, sure.
Oh, well, that's fine.
Goodbye.
Have fun in hell.
Hey now! You simply won't believe how much this book will change your life. This book will change your life.
Hey guys, I've got all these extra resources we can learn to study with.
No, no, no. That's not how you do it. You're making things up again. Just stick to the approved dialogue. MI5, show him.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to
Sunshine Coast.
And we would like to share with you this Bible of their school.
Hello, hello.
Ding dong, hi ho.
Just buy this book.
You mean download for free?
You simply won't believe how much this book will change your life. This book will change your life. So don't go to TC.
Hello.
You'll graduate someday. And if you read this book, you'll see that there's an easier way. Not on GC. Now we are family. We can fully guarantee you that this book will change your life. 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 The Book of Tally. O'Connor.
Hello.
folks at home, welcome back to another week of the Bachelor MD. I hope you're all excited. I certainly am. Just a quick recap of what happened last week. We were left on a complete cliffhanger with our MD Dermot given the opportunity of a lifetime, an afternoon off.
Having an afternoon off is just the best feeling. I've definitely had my heart broken before, and I'm not proud to admit it. But in the past, I've definitely taken my free time for granted. Free time's scary, and I'm scared of getting hurt. But I finally think I'm ready to put myself out there again. And who knows? Maybe tonight, I'll meet the recreational activity of my dreams.
All right, Dermot. Well, we have six beautiful contestants. Are you ready to meet them?
100%.
Well, since we're all medical students, we don't have time to sit through individual dates with each of our contestants. So much like a DISA lecture that you watch at 2x speed, we're just gonna skip to the high yield aspects of the dates so that you can get to know our contestants on a superficial level, the way that God intended.
Perfect.
Hey there. My name is Anki. Some people call me a tease because I'm hard to understand. You'll never fully finish me. And I always keep you coming back for more. And don't forget my sexually active recall.
G'day, mate. I'm procrastination. We can do whatever you want. Cooking, cleaning, masturbating, as long as none of that study shit.
Hi, Daddy. I'm Ambos, and I'm extensively peer-reviewed. So ask around. I'll be the best you've ever had. And you can have all of me, free for 5 days. But then you better hand over those credit cards, or I'll find somebody else who'll pay for my concise summary tables.
Hi, I'm DHC. I've been a bit unlucky in love in the past. In the lead up to exams, all the boys message me. But then, as soon as they're over, they just leave me on read and they don't message anymore, and I just guess I'm scared I'm gonna be alone.
Hi, I'm Netflix and Chill. I'm just a girl who loves curling up on the couch. Who knows what will be happening when Netflix asks, "Are you still watching?"
Hey, I'm Social Life. Wow, you're like so handsome. Do you want to go to Rice Boy with me? Or Ocean Street? Or we could go to a house party and then Ocean Street. Don't you just love people and parties and love and life and people and... Oh my God,
I'm so excited. Dermot, are you ready to make your decision?
All of these choices are so tempting. And I've made so many deep connections. Some even balls deep. But a decision has to be made. On the one hand, if I don't pick Anki today, I know she, and I think it's she, will be so much more work tomorrow. On the other hand, I really think Social Life could help me become a well-rounded person. I have to follow my heart, and there's only one person I want to give my stethoscope to. DHC?
Wait. Dermot. Don't waste your stethoscope on DHC. She's open book. You can control F her later. I'm so sorry, folks. Unfortunately, Dermot just took too long deciding what to do. Oh, well. Better luck next time, DHC. Now I'm taking Anki all for myself.
As some of you may remember, earlier this year, the Gums academic team hosted an event named Stump the Gums, inspired by the popular podcast I Am Reasoning. A local ABC radio reporter was interested in this event and decided to put together a really nice story, which included interviews with the podcast hosts, Art and Nick. What was not planned, however, was what followed when ABC posted the story to Facebook with the caption, "How do doctors work out what's wrong with you?"
So just read it quickly and then you can go back.
Hold up, hold up. They do 300 cards on the G deck every night before they sleep. Colin or Skippy commented that they try and figure out what the hidden pun in your name is so they can link it to a diagnosis. Colin or Skippy? Colonoscopy. Most doctors are just drug dealers. I find Dr. Google much more informed and provides the right diagnosis and advice than most GPs. We already know what is wrong. GPs are only good for the piece of paper to take to the cast. If the standard tests come back okay, they just dismiss you. If you are a woman. If you are a woman. After 32 years of trying to find answers about issues I've had since I was born,
3 hours later,
I found out what it was on Reddit, of all places. Google? 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 Bing? Bing? Google, Google, Google. What a joke. They guess what's wrong with you 9 out of 10 times, hence why we are forever going back to get a different medication to treat something. Most doctors these days act like they got their license out of a Weet-Bix box. How many do you do?
Hey, mate.
Hey, Ham.
Got some knee pain.
Really sorry to hear that.
Thanks. Do you know what's wrong with me?
I can try. Can you characterize the pain for me? So, is it dull, sharp, burning, or aching?
Dull.
Okay. Do you? And in terms of severity, 0 being no pain at all, and 10 being the worst pain you've ever felt, can you rate it between 0 and 10?
4.
They attend Griffith University's clinical reasoning workshops.
That's how I respond. That's how I react. That's my. Yeah, some people cry. Some people laugh. Shit.
Hypernatremic, and you can be hyponatremic. Can you just be natremic?
I think you can in Europe.
Have any of you ever heard of the clitoris?
Do you mean the clitoris? Like, yeah, it's the center for female pleasure.
No, it's a myth. I've never been able to find it.
Do you know what I've heard is not a myth? Speculum.
Speculum, yes, I've heard of them.
Wait, what's a speculum?
I think you mean, whose speculum? How do I even begin to explain?
I heard they did fig scrubs commercials in Japan.
I heard their Lippmans are insured for $1 million.
One time, Speculum met Troy Stapleton in the hallways, and he told them they were smart.
Well, I heard that Speculum wears RMs and Birkenstocks, so I went and bought RMs and Birkenstocks.
One time, Speculum pimped me during ward rounds. It was awesome.
Wow. Speculum sounds so fetch. But I still don't know who they are.
No one knows who they are. But apparently, they're a shifty organization in the shadows of Griffith Med.
You see, this is the problem with this cohort. Instead of practicing your clinical skills, you are all sitting around serving the tea.
But Sooj, we have a DHC assignment.
I don't care about DHC. Back when I was a medical student, we didn't sleep. We survived on the smell of electrocautery. And medical students fear not learning about public health. Look at you lot. We have a long way to go. It's time to sharpen up and scrub up.
Never gonna practice this.
Please can you take your shirt off?
99 ATAR not helping me now.
This guy looks scared to death.
When do we get to suture?
Never really wish that I had read the handout.
Must be swift as an Oski station, as sterile as the CSS, with all the strength of a massive. Who needs social skills when your patients are asleep? Time is racing toward us till placement begins. Heed my every order and you might survive. You're unsuited for the theater, so pack up. Go home, get through. How can I make surgeons out of you?
You must be swift as an Oski station, as sterile as the CSS, with all the strength of a masseter, who needs social skills when your patients are asleep. Must be swift as an Oski station, as sterile as the CSS, with all the strength of the masseter, who needs social skills when your patients are
today we're filming the Chats music video. I'm sure you remember the last one filmed right here at Sky. Check it out. anything interesting? I might gather. Excuse me, we're filming. We're just filming in here. That's it. I've got a gun. It's on you. Keep it rolling. This is good content. So me and Antonio have found somewhere safe. I'm not sure what's going on. It's a code black. So we're in a code black. There's people running around with guns, and the lecturers have been kidnapped. I hope this video doesn't flop. This should be so good for my views. I just have one really important thing to say. So for my new OnlyFans out, please just go and link in my bio. Let's check it out. Like, follow, subscribe. Thank you.
Greetings, Griffith Medical students. We are Speculum. I see you're all looking a bit stressed. What's wrong? Sonia placed you rurally. Well, you're probably wondering where your beloved MI5 are. We have them, and we are not afraid to hurt them. Slowly and painfully, like a DHC. We have one simple request. Give us $2 million or they die in the next 72 hours. Better act quick. Like med ball ticket sales, time is running out.
Our lecturers at SKU have been taken by this Speculum organisation. Honestly, what a pain. I could just pay the ransom. It is only $2 million. But I think there's a valuable lesson to be learned here, students. Money doesn't save all your problems, eh, Bond? Regardless, I'm asking you to save our lecturers from being hostage and stop me from involving myself in these trivial problems. One last thing. Stop skipping Community Week!
Surely this is low yield. Can't he just get him back for us?
The whole point of this exercise is to throw us in the deep end. Otherwise we won't learn.
Give me a break. Why does this have to be another group assignment?
Well, if we're going to be doing a group assignment, maybe you should swing me your Instagram, Bond, just so we can work together.
You're going to have to learn how to work in a team environment in the future anyway. Let's just figure out what happened to the MI5.
Shooting from the hip here, but I'm pretty sure they were taken by Ubuntu Through Health.
Why would Ubuntu Through Health kidnap and ransom Jen Williams?
I don't know, man. Maybe they needed to pay for the boat breaking down at Jungle Party.
That's such a great differential. How about you send me your Twitter? What's the Speculum thing again?
Oh, well, a speculum is a duckbill-shaped device, and it's commonly used to examine ladies down their parts.
Nice.
Ew.
Grow up, boys. That's not helpful. Why would Speculum even take our lecturers? Nat wouldn't hurt a fly, and think about poor Lisa's dog.
Some men aren't looking for anything logical, like money. They can't be bought, bullied, reasoned, or negotiated with. Some men just want to watch the world burn.
Oh my God, that was so profound. Hey, Bon, give me your ping ID.
That's literally just a Dark Knight quote.
Can we take this seriously for once? Let's just go to Sky and figure this out.
Suge, we've been looking for you. How did you get free?
Hey. Remember, students, never palpate both carotids. It seems like...
And that is the end of Act 1. Back here in 30 minutes.
sewage reviews where Griffith's eminent educator saves the public from bad service and experiences. They say that pen is mightier than the sword, so let's see what one man can do with a Google account and a keyboard. As you can see here, Mothenpick makes the egregious mistake of non-standardised portion sizing with their ice cream scoops, earning a damning one-star review. Many people say quality over quantity, but obviously not when it comes to ice cream. But now we have Runcimillion, who have a stellar 5-star review for their wide selection of rugs. In no time, you'll be snug as a bug in a rug, thanks to our bargain-hunting entrepreneurs. We will never know what the big pelican did to earn this middle-of-the-road 3 stars, but I pray that our feathered friend is not disgruntled from this ambivalent review. I wonder if any of our other big animals, or big fruit, will earn respect from our shrewd sejula. In a move that snubs a local Gold Coast icon, Robina Town Centre taps the cake over Australia Fair. Notice the rare smiley face emoticon, which really encapsulates the joy that our dear Sejiwa feels about the range available at Robina Shopping Centre. Chin chin! When a review starts with all caps, you know it's rarely going to be positive. Unfortunately for our friends at JB Hi-Fi, Sejiwa is the judge, juror, and executioner of the Google review pages. Their customer service has been deemed unsatisfactory in a blistering play-by-play. Oh, burn! And that brings us to the close of this episode of Sued Reviews. I do hope that you will join us again to see the scrupulous judgments of our fearless leader, Sejiwa.
Welcome back from intermission. You guys having a good time? Good to hear. If you're not, the bar's back there. Just go have a couple more drinks and I'm sure you'll be having a great one. Tonight we have something very special, which is the first ever Sunshine Coast Rap Battle. We have 4 gangsters lined up to answer the age-old question, which year is the best? Now, I'm going to need your help at the end, so be ready for that when we get to the end of our epic rap battle. First off, we have Boy Wonder Simon, who hails from Brisbane, and we'll be repping the first years. He may be from Brizzy, but his rap sounds like it's from Logan. So put your hands together for Simon.
Hey, this one goes out to a special lady in the crowd. You know who you are. Hey, Med Revue 2021. Let's do this. First things first, rest in peace to the years. First years, you the only real ones that I ever knew. I go to sky to try and be a better you. Mission statements that I made way back in the year. Fulfilled, even back when I didn't know Sam McGill. Cavendish would have still been an Alapril. Consult my drillers. One time for my PBL sisters. One time for my PBL hoes. Facilitators can't tell the difference. One time for a doctor who knows. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. No role models and we're here right now. No role models to speak of. Search through the screw crew, my LinkedIn. I couldn't find one. Last night I was getting my heart rubbed by the smartest guy, not Arjun, but I swear to God this guy would make you call the tutor up and tell him understood. Sorry, I'm going home now and I'ma stay for good. I hang the phone up, I proceed to push doof. I am faster than Josh G and Valorant. Ain't got no shame about it. I got smaller than a rich cause I'm a lucky mitts. I bitch, I got defensive ends and now I was the same in high school. Then I thought back to a better me. Before I was a med-sized celebrity, before I started bowling on the really so heavily. Back to when Gen Obi-Wan was just a memory, you wasn't sweating me. One time for my med-sized sisters. One time for my choosy hoes. Non-med don't know the difference. One time for a postgrad who knows. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved, don't save them. They don't want to be saved, don't save them. We don't want to be saved, we want a real love. That Jen and Hamish love, that Harris and Malak love. That leave your med scrubs and your crib love. And you ain't gonna want the weather, that's your kit love. Ali, I don't want a chick random manifestos. Out of touch with reality, hoes. Out of PBL9, doing 5 or 6 of lows. Do them, then we stick them on the board. Nick, you know how it goes, you deserve that. You nerd to nerd rap. You think if I didn't rap, they wouldn't clap back. Taking off my crown, let me take a bow before I leave. But I need that crown back. Carlos, you know how it goes. One time for my first year sisters. One time for my second year hoes. Third years don't know the difference. One time for a fourth year knows. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. They don't want to be saved. Don't save them. They don't want to be saved. Thank you, Bettina. I love you.
Damn, what a great start to a rap battle. Next, we have G Money to see if she can top that. Now, we know that she can act and she can dance, so let's see if she can cement her triple threat status with a bit of a rap. Take it away, G.
Come on!
Yeah.
I remember getting intimate because of social skills and missing that GPA just so I could get an interview. Now all these first year kids be shutting parties down at 9:50, probably on P. Like, teacher, mommy, pack your lunch for you. Bitch, I'ma scrub my hands up good once I'm done with ya. Oh, you better sit while I make this next incision. My primary intention to cause wounds, just so you know. Pull up to your walls and break it down just like an author. Urges think they OGs, but they just delirious. Get some thiamine, cause you're confabulating, If the fog is left, I wouldn't even notice, Do you even go here? I've just never noticed ya. Oh, G-Deck, help that learning spiral. Highest ratio of women in our cohort. And don't forget, we kicked your ass at playing b-ball. We let them win at you and I. Bitch, be humble. Sit down. Be humble. Sit down. Be humble. Bitch, sit down.
Well then, that's gonna be pretty hard to beat. shit. So our next rapper might not look like much, and some say he's whiter than Coles brand white bread. But let's see if Hamish can toast it up the competition for the third years.
Yeah. Let's go. Now Jen and Ted once told me the GC wanna own me, but they ain't the sharpest tools in the shed. GC looking kinda dumb with their fingers and their thumbs in the shape of grip tape on their forehead. Well, the years started coming and they don't stop coming. Smashed all their rules and we hit the ground running. Didn't make sense to use Blackboard. Year one's already on the ward. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with doing my anky? You'll never know what you don't know. You'll never shine if you don't grow. Hey now, you're year three. Get your Steth on an Oscar day. Hey now, do your Oscar. Get the show on, no pay. But GCR, all mine. And only Scoot stars. Year three's a cool place, and it don't get any cooler. You're pre-clin now, wait till you get older. Your clin skills make Cali quiver, judging by how you felt the liver. The school's air lows are a bunch of crap. I'm standing in theatre retracting a flap. My ears bars fire, your PBL's bored. That's why I'm in third year and you're getting ignored. Hey now, you're a pre-clin. Take your Seth off, go play. Hey now, let's do your LI. Go to GPLP. The GC are still mud. And only Scoot stars. Break it down.
Yep.
Hey now, you're year three, get your stent on Oscar tape. Hey now, do your Oscar, get the show on, no pay. But GCR all mud, and only Scoot does. Some consultant once asked what the law of Laplace and what's it doing to your bowel gas. I said, wow, what a concept. I could only take a random guess, but tell me the answer anyway. Well, the year fours are coming and they all try gunning. We were here first, we're already running. Doesn't make sense to mess with us. Put a smile on your face, practice mindfulness. Welcome to school, now that you're free. Nothing's wrong with losing to 40. Aren't you glad you changed your postcode? You're only gonna miss the no! Hey now, you're year three. Get your stent on Oscar Tay. Hey now, do your Oscar. Get the show on, no pay. A GCR all mud, and only Scoo stars. Love. Everybody now, GCR all mud, and only Scoo stars. Love.
White boy can rap. So, last of all, and not least, we have Isla, whose alter ego, Queen Trainee, has come tonight's show with the fourth years of GOT. Let's see if she can... Let's see if she can live up to her name in the last rap tonight. So put your hands together for Isla.
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the best med student please stand up? I repeat, will the best med student please stand up? We're gonna have a problem here. You'll act like you've never seen competence before. Dog's jaws on the floor when I walk through the door. Ted Weaver and I are catching babies, front, left, right and centre. Step aside, PHO, I'll get the placenta. Oh wait, the intern is here? He gets to the job, I do better, does he? And the intern said, nothing, you idiots, the intern's dead, he's locked in my basement. Inferior cohorts love me, they call me Queen Trainee, they wanna be me. Look, they're flipping the you-know-what. Diagnosing you-know-who, oh, she's so gifted. Be quiet, shut up, I'll Aberdeen knot your pie hole shut. I don't need to be convinced that you suck. Your admission to med school was pure luck, and even I can't teach you schmucks. Pissed off with your clinical skills infirmity. Took you 3 years to get a 2-year degree. You've come to the party late. Sort of impressive with a GCS of 8. By the time I was a 4th year, inpatients bought my photo as a souvenir. I can interpret ECGs flawlessly. You're struggling with a flat EEG. I will send you straight into a systole. I'm bored of you, honestly. You haven't earned those RMs, so some loves me and my bros and hoes. 4th years, wave your stethoscope, sing the chorus and it goes. I'm Queen Trainee, yes, I'm the real trainee. All you other trainees are just imitating. So won't the best med student please stand up? Please stand up, please stand up. I'm Queen Trainee, yes, I'm the real trainee. All you other trainees are just imitating. So won't the best med student please stand up? Please stand up, please stand up. J-Hos get paid for the same work that I do. Well, I don't, so fuck them and fuck you too. You think I give a damn about seniority? Half you dimwits don't comprehend me, let alone challenge me. But Isla, have patience and look at you. Why? I'm clearly the queen in the suit. Just sit me next to Judith and Jen so I can advise them on the curriculum. Dr. Sprothetter, finally a student. Where is they compare you to rodents? I can interpret your ABG. Basic bitches, it reads. Hee hee. I get introduced as trainee doctor with my other shorties. They confuse you for warties. I'm sick of your PBL groups, they annoy me. So I've been sent here to destroy you. And you wish you were just like me. Can you late like me? Intubate like me? Auscultate like me? Isbound refer like me? But you'll never be quite like me. I'm the OG, yes, from the GC. All you other wannabes, get on your knees. So won't the best med student please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. I'm the real deal, don't care how you feel. Your shitty fate is pretty much sealed. So won't the best med student please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Oi, loser, come shadow me in your Friday ED shift. It's my gift to you. Consider it charity. You will never be allowed to use PPE. That's for important staff like me. I can handle any med call. A code blue gets called when you fall. School and sky are my stadiums, and I ponder, do you need some Valiums? At the rate you're going when you're 30, you'll be at Booper cleaning up the dirty, cause you spit on speculums you're inserting. You're the reason my dress code's been converting. You can type my notes for me as you're lurking. I'll be the next dean of medicine, Professor Hazelton, expelling you for professional breaches. Even Farmer Joe won't let you near his stitches. So will the best med student please stand up? Sit your ass back down, sell your scrubs and quit now. I'm about to be gone out of here. You can refer to me, your senior colleague. We are the MVPs, the best of our team. All your other colleagues are just irritating. So won't the best med student please stand up? Please stand up, please stand up, cause we're soon free without any fees. All your other colleagues are just irritating, so won't the best med student please stand up, please stand up, please stand up. Guess I'm done with you. Fuck it. We're graduating.
All right. So we've had four fantastic raps, but we need to decide who's a winner. So, let's do this by cheers. First years, if do you think Simon was the best, give us a bit of a cheer. Yeah. All right. And what if you thought G Money had it tonight? What about our man Hamish? He did toast it up tonight. What do you think? And finally, the queen trainee herself, Isla. I think we have a winner. Well done, guys.
Oh man, did you guys hear those carotid bruis? This is getting really bad. If we don't solve this, I'll never make anatomy tutor by next year. My life will be ruined!
Calm down, you Gen Zers are so dramatic. It's not the end of the world. It sounded like it was coming from the sky building.
What are you thinking, sexy? I mean, Bond?
Well, as the handsomest, smartest, and just all-round best med student at this university, I think I should take the lead. Come on, baby. Use that orbicularis oris muscle and give me some glucose.
Ew, no. Why is he like this?
Whatever, your loss. Here's my idea. I think we go straight to Sky. If that's where the action is, that's where I gotta be.
Come on, Bon. That's stupid. We don't know what's happening. If you do that, you're gonna end up a cadaver. Not that anyone from Sunny Coast even knows what a cadaver looks like.
Yeah, we've got to be careful, Bon. Just think of your gorgeous face.
Guys, you need to chillax, all right? I am Bond, the smartest med student at this university. I don't need any of your help.
Guys, we literally started here a week ago. We don't know enough about the med school. We need to find someone that knows the inner workings of Griffith. And we need to work together. Med is a team sport.
Yeah, we really should. Stick together.
Group work is just like bad sex. It's painful and you're just praying for it to be over.
Well, it's nice to know you at least have some idea what girls think when they're with you. Can we get back to the issue at hand? I think I know where we can get information on where the lecturers are. The librarians have eyes and ears everywhere. Surely they can point us in the right direction.
That idea is equivalent to DHC. It's useless, makes no sense, and is a complete waste of time. So, what if we go with my idea?
Come on, Bond. We all have to work together here. My mom always says that teamwork makes the dream work when she tucks me in at night.
Aw, Q. You know nothing. It's hard for me to say, but I've got to do what's best for me. I'm leaving.
Is
Be a surgeon.
You must be swift as an Oski station.
Be a surgeon.
As sterile as the CSF.
Be a surgeon.
With all the strength of the masseter. Who needs social skills when your patients are asleep? All right, you were a little flat there. What the fuck?
It seems that our evil plan isn't working. We need to find other ways to make money. Perhaps we should get more leverage. Capture that Bond kid. With the name Bond, surely his parents have some money to throw around. Send in my dancers to capture him.
This is like a nightmare I've had.
Wait, what's going on here? No, not my hands. These are future surgeon hands.
I'm telling you to loosen up my buttons, better. But you keep frontin', say what you gon' do to me. But I ain't seen nothing. I'm telling you to loosen up my buttons, better. But you keep frontin', say what you gon' do to me. But I ain't seen nothing. You gon' do to me, but I ain't seen nothing. I'm telling you to loosen up my buttons, baby. But you keep running.
What are we going to do now?
Do they ever do any work? I swear they're either just online shopping or just fixing the script. Oh, there they are!
Lucy!
Not so good, Sue. We were hoping you could help us. The med school's under attack by Speculum and we've been sent on a mission to find the lecturers.
Let me guess. Griffith just refuses to pay the ransom. Shocking!
Do you know anything about this or have any information about Speculum?
We may know something, but it's gonna cost you.
Come on, we're just poor med students. We can't afford it.
It's not going to cost you money. It'll cost you an interesting trivia fact. And if they are not good enough, all students will pay for printing.
All right, I got one for you. Did you know that some species of turtles can actually breathe out their butts?
Really?
Yeah, and did you know that it takes the same amount of pressure to bite through a carrot as it does a finger? I've kept it in mind in case Bond gets handsy.
Oh, Jasper, that will do. You didn't hear it from us, but Speculum may not be what it appears to be.
What do you mean?
Get ready for some piping hot tea. What have you heard about the tensions between the Gold and Sunshine Coast?
Well, we've heard Jen and Suge mention things from time to time, but we didn't think it was anything serious.
Yeah, what are you saying?
What if the Sunshine Coast did something to distance themselves from the Gold Coast?
Wait, that couldn't possibly be.
MI5 weren't kidnapped. They were the ones that planned the whole damn thing.
So our mission isn't to find and rescue MI5, it's to capture them? How are we going to do that?
It's not going to be easy, but we have a mole on the inside that might be able to help.
Ah, well, that's good because I know all about moles. Asymmetry, borders, color, ABC, diameter, evolution.
Who's the mole?
Snoop! Over there! He's seen everything! Just look at him over there! Why do you think he just sits and stares out the window all day? It's why his hair is so big. It's full of secrets. What's that, Snoop? They've kidnapped students. A dick rider. Oh, my God.
Yeah, we're still not calling him that.
We have to go find them, Q. Where can we find this mole?
Level 3 sky building. You better hurry.
Are you sure this is the best we've got, Agent Gardner?
I'm afraid so.
Well, I want you to initiate the COVID endgame protocol. Dark times call for the most degenerate measures.
Enter. Now, let's patch this bad boy up.
What the fuck are you doing?
Settle down. She'll be alright, mate. Got you sorted. Please report your findings.
Well,
thanks to you folks. They're soft. I fixed them up, so she'll be right. Practice real medicine up north. Next!
Doctor, thank God you're here.
Ew, get off me. This suits Armani. Just let me handle it.
Oh, I forgot my cotton bud.
All good. We'll just use this. There we go. Hold that down.
Are you sure you're a doctor? I don't think I trust you.
Well, maybe you should have got private health insurance, you peasant.
Report your findings.
Yeah, so I have no idea what's going on medically, but Daddy says money solves all problems. But he's poor, so I guess he's fucked. Anyway,
Daddy said this would help you pass. Next student.
Hi, I'm a fourth year medical student. I really like your shirt, it's so nice. It really brings out your eyes. Do you want to be friends? I feel like we could be really great friends.
I don't know, weirdo.
Oh, sorry. Okay, before I start, I'm just going to practice some mindfulness.
For the love of God, can you just please take a fucking history?
Okay. Can you tell me more about that? I'm so sorry. Can you tell me more? Can you tell me more? Can you tell me more?
Please report your progress.
Okay, so this is Greg. He is a 40-year-old male and he lives at home with his dog, and it's a really sad story because all his friends died and he used to play bingo, but now he doesn't play bingo anymore!
I go to YouTube. I'm a real doctor. Look, I need you to take your shirt off.
Excuse me, this is a Breaking Bad news station.
Oh yeah, that's right. Look, you have like the worst possible cancer I've ever seen. Like it's in the bones, it's in the lungs. It's so like rare. Actually, could I write this up as an Oscar? Please, I've got 500 other peers. Please.
No thanks.
Yeah, breaking bad news, insert empathy, insert emotions. What else do I want? I want a full blood count, I want an MRI, I want anal swabs. I want to look down your throat, to be honest. Let's have a look, come in.
Please. Call the code black, it's a UQ student.
Come on! Oh, come on, alright, I got a UQ, I'll just give you guys COVID instead.
Here are the assessments of all the new recruits.
I knew med students were dumb, but this is just sad.
Could be worse. Have you seen those USC kids? They're pathetic.
Well, one thing's for certain.
Are you sure we're in the right place? It's so dark here.
Yes, I'm sure this is the place. Sue couldn't lie. Sue would never lie.
Why is it so dark here?
I think this is where the radiology regs go to practice.
Practice? For what?
Practice for their new lives. Careful, they haven't seen the sun in years. That can do weird things to people.
Ah! I'm scared.
It's okay, Q. Luckily, I brought my trusty pen light with me. A back, heathens!
Look, over there. An ominous, backlit figure shrouded in mystery.
That must be the mole.
Judith!
Hello!
Wait, so Judith, you were part of this plan the whole time?
Unfortunately, yes. I thought deflecting from Gold Coast would mean things would run more smoothly around here. But spectacles, or whatever they call themselves, are even more unorganized than the ladies at Fit for Placement. I was wondering if you needed some help.
Can you tell us where they've taken Ryder?
And Bond.
Yeah, him too. They've taken them somewhere no one would ever think to go. Somewhere no one would ever dare to venture.
The DHC admin offices! Thanks, Judith. Where are those, actually?
You'll need a map. Here's one I've prepared earlier. I've advised Pierre, the after-hour security guard, to let you in through the side entrance. Take a left, go through the computer lab, whereupon you'll meet Rachel, who will guide you through a set of winding corridors infested with twosies. Here, I prepared screenshots of 100% correct answer streaks on past med. This should incapacitate them. Keep going till you reach the USC admin offices, where you'll find a stash backpack full of clinical tools to help you in your fight against Speculum. Take a right, and you'll arrive at your destination. I've also called your mother, Moneypenny, and sent her flowers for her birthday, and booked you, Q, in for your annual flu shot. Here are your snacks for the journey. Other than that, you're on your own. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Oh my God.
Oh, you're the best, Judith. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye.
Jude, 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 best by far. A problem, she is ready. I email her almost every second day. Fights a GoPro stop for us if we nay. Especially the gals from Triple Play Smart. She'll start it out, oh, have no doubt. Queen with no crown, a queen with no crown.
To ransom Mr. Bond so we can fund the JCU, the Gen Clinical University.
I think we should probably workshop that name a little. Must be why our GoFundMe failed. Mm. Who even is this guy?
Are you? You're finally awake.
Hey, my guy Siege. Don't worry, mate. Everything's gonna be okay. I'll get us out of here. Wait. Why aren't you tied up?
Unfortunately, you have missed the signs, and therefore, you have missed the diagnosis.
Yes, young Padawan, your negligence has indeed clouded your judgment.
Wait, what's going on here?
Welcome, Mr. Bond. You can just call me the Wesley Hospital, because boy, do I have a surprise for you. Can you guess our master plan? I'll start you off. Any ideas?
I have no clue.
You really are a bonded student. Well, we are planning to start a brand new university, free from Griffith, the Gen Clinical University. or J, C, U.
But what made you do this?
Is that what you guys do when you're not teaching around here? Can you untie me? My lawyer will hear about this.
Actually, the Hospital and Health Boards Act states that there are no legal ramifications for our actions. I doubt you'll get a cent from us.
I can't wait for our ransom money to come in so we can buy all our new uni students copies of Talion O'Connor.
Surely not everyone needs
You know nothing,
Talion.
Young boy.
This plan is inevitable. Nothing can fail, no matter how hard you struggle.
Don't lecture me anymore, you fiends. You won't get away with this. Griffith will come for you.
You'll often find reality is disappointing. At least it was at Griffith. A gen clinical university, reality can be whatever we want it to be.
Thank you.
It's really dark in here.
It's a little awkward, isn't it?
They couldn't afford the lighting, could they?
Classic Griffith.
Yeah.
All right, we've made it. Now we just have to figure out how to defeat the Spartans. Right. God, this plot is confusing.
We should probably save the others while we're at it. Unless...
No, damn it, we can't. We need those two idiots for our deal-up debate team.
This is highly undignified. Daddy will not be happy.
That sounds like our man.
Guys, we've come to save you.
Oh, thank God. Where are the rest of you?
The rest of us?
Yes, the rest of the cohort coming to save their fearless general.
It's just us.
No chopper?
Nope.
No flash grenades?
Afraid not.
Well, this is very disappointing.
For all of us.
All right, so I got these super special scissors that Judith gave us. So all free rider, you do Bond.
Nice.
I'll just cut the wrist ties first, yeah?
Nah, I'm okay.
What do you mean?
I'm fine like this.
What?
Please let me have this.
Guys, you won't believe what I discovered while you two were off dilly-dallying around. The lecture
is a speculum.
Wait, you guys already knew?
I mean, it was pretty obvious. That was Jen's voice in the video, and I'm pretty sure it was shot in her office.
I can't believe this.
Believe what, Bond? That you are yet again the last person in your cohort to understand something?
Guys, I'm not dumb, all right? I know lots of medical things about medicine, all right? I'm a good boy.
That's right. You are a boy. Unfortunately for you, there will be no boys in my new world order. Attack, Sooj!
Oh, damn, that boy a sergeant.
Oh, damn, he kinda cute.
The only reason you think the clitoris is a myth is because you've never found one.
Damn!
Yeah, well, your mum. I can't do this. He's too strong. And he's a surgeon. I want to be him. I can't do it alone.
Don't cross me, darling. I'll make sure all you do in third and fourth years are rectal exams.
We'll address the sexism later. I've got you, Bond. How about I have a little chat to the Ombudsman about your course profiles?
Yoink!
Get in there, Q.
Let's see what you've learned. Just think about a patient who's been diagnosed with diabetes.
That must be so hard for you. Bad sugars are a real bitch, hey?
You still haven't learned that it doesn't matter if you know tally and quad back to front. If you can't talk to patients, then it doesn't mean a thing.
I'm so sorry for what you're going through. I can't even imagine what it would be like.
Maybe things aren't so bad, if even a med psy can learn empathy.
You must see Murphy Brown's Instagram. She looks so cute.
Woof woof, motherfucker.
I can help. Even though you're a fierce queen and have a cute dog, I will still take you down.
When I'm done with you, they're going to convict me of professional misconduct.
Well, I know someone who has the cutest cavoodle to be adopted. Just drop this and remove all the DLEP assessment for the year and we can sort something out.
Well, Murphy does need a friend, and it would be so cute to dress them in matching costumes.
Gotcha! I was wearing a wire the whole time. Wait till QCat hears about this.
Judith, help us! No matter who wins, I still have to sort out all the placements.
Please, you don't learn useful things at Griffith. Can't you see we will be better off at my new JCU, where we won't be constrained by the Gold Coast? If you don't back down, I'll make sure all your internships are 2 years long.
Maybe what Moneypenny said before was right. We are better when we work together. Who knew a woman could be right? This will take all of us together. We have to use everything we've learned.
Yeah, sure. Sometimes Griffiths forget to tell lecturers when they have online lectures to deliver.
And no, they don't understand that Ping ID two-factor authentication is literally the most inconvenient, idiotic, and inoperative way to access Blackboard.
And yes, they can't afford anatomy professors because they spent the entire budget on a useless anatomage table.
But Griffith is our university, and we are better off together in the School of Medicine.
Wow, maybe I was wrong. Now that I think about it, JCU does have a ring to it that sounds like sweat, mosquitoes, and being rural. I'll back down, for now.
Where's my money?
Five were Speculum. Watch, students, forget about that empathy bullshit. I'll show you how some real motivational interviewing is done. Lisa, how about we lift the no dogs in the office rule? Sooj, how about monthly 5 hour long Sooj sessions where you can teach the students whatever you bloody want? Nat, we both know those communication scenarios need some updating. And Jen, how about you get Sunny Coast bragging rights, where we bring a representative up from the Gold Coast, we sit them down, and they have to agree with you and say, yes, Jen, the Sunshine Coast is better than the Gold Coast.
Well, Miss Murphy has been rather lonely since we've been back at the office.
And they could do with some knot-tying skills.
And some of those comm scenarios really are terrible.
And the Sunshine Coast is better than the Gold Coast.
The jury has deliberated your proposal and come to a unanimous decision. Deal.
Yay! Oh, Bond, you've got a cough.
Yeah, I wonder what happened to that med student who had a cough before.
Say a little prayer, get your money, man. Like
no, I'm hopeful. Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take.
So when right go wrong, just say a little prayer, get your money, man. Like
no, I'm hopeful. Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it.
Little prayer, get your money, man. Like
no, I'm hopeful. Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away.
So when right go wrong, just say a little prayer. Get your money, man. Life goes on.
I'm hopeful. Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it.
Go wrong, just say a little prayer. Get your money, man. Life goes
on. I'm hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it.
Get your money, man. Life goes
on. I'm hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it.
Go wrong, just say a little prayer. Get your money, man. Life goes on.
I'm hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today, take this music.
Right, go wrong, just say a little prayer. Get your money, man, life goes
on. I'm hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today, take this music and use it. Let it take you away and be hopeful, hopeful. And he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, cause we
almost over the school review. We have to leave now, but we thank you. Bond has saved the day in our little play. Tried to make some sense of a Gold Coast RCA med review. Time to go home. Study the mechanisms of ceftriaxone placement tomorrow. Go get some sleep. See you next year at school review. All my memories of the last hour, without the bond near, they'd be pretty sour. We've had some good laughs, some awkward chuckles too, but we've had a great time, and we hope so did you. Med review, it's over. We hope it wasn't mediocre. Most of us now uneven sober. Cerebellar dysfunction, sensory motor. Still at school, if you're rural, no review for you. You need to go home from med review. So it's goodbye from a school review.
Ladies and gentlemen, School Review 2021.
Without the blood, sweat, and tears of many, many people, this show would not have been possible.
There are many events that I'm so proud that Gums has brought to the Sunshine Coast.
Our cast are very proud too. Medball, Battle of the Bruce, and now, Med Review.
Not only have these events been incredibly fun, although kind of stressful to run, it's been amazing to see how many people have banded together to make these events possible.
The beauty of seeing this show take place has been watching people from so many different talents come together to produce such an incredible Med Review.
From backstage to videos to those showcasing their talents tonight, it has been an honour for us to coordinate the event.
We'd like to do a few special thank yous tonight. So I'm wondering if some cast could pop back out. Firstly, Liz Mattinson. Liz, you have faithfully lugged a U Foods box full of props and an Excel spreadsheet to and from Sky about 20 times in the last month. Thank you so much for your dedication to the cause and for taking such good care of Ruff, my precious puppy that cameoed as Murphy Brown.
Secondly, Simon. He's the rap battle savant and the Med Review writer. You've done it all, mate. We're very lucky to have you on the team.
Josh Great. And then allowing us to rope you in not only as the Gums IT Officer 2022, but the official tech guy for tonight. Thank you for answering my constant boomer questions. It's always appreciated.
So in saying that, we want to say thank you to everyone who participated and directed all the videos tonight. Some of you are in the audience right now, and we just want to say... So now... I think they know who they are. On to three big guns. Georgia. Thank you for bringing all your years of dance experience and talent to Med Review. It's been fantastic to work with you to solve all the odd challenges that Med Review has brought. Also, thank you for taking the time to choreograph and teach even the most challenging of students. Boys?
Alex? Alex, you have been nothing but a pleasure to work with. Thank you for all the time you've spent pulling together the chorus and working out the details that really make this show what it is. Thank you for always listening to me stress out and for always bringing snacks to rehearsals. It makes all of the difference.
And lastly, definitely not leastly, Master Josh Gardner. So Josh, you were the first to be roped into this crazy adventure on a Teams call that I seem to remember me having with you. Thank you for all the time, effort, and dedication you brought to the team. Your direction has truly made Med Review into what it is today, and it's been my absolute pleasure to work with you, mate.
This thank you really goes out to all of you here at SCU. Everyone that has stood up and volunteered their time and talent to make this show happen. Because of you, Med Review now exists at SCU.
So, I think it's pretty fair to say tonight that the Scoo crew truly are the best med students, colleagues, and friends one could ever, ever ask for. Let's go. Come on, everybody out. Scoo crew, get on the stage. Get on the stage.
For those of you who would like to party on with our cast tonight, we are heading to Club Kiwana. Make sure you grab something to eat before we go because their kitchen is closed and we have to eat before we drink. But once again, thank you all for attending the inaugural Scoo Med Revue.